Good afternoon, everyone. It's a very difficult to speak after Rick Roberts. Anyway, I try to share some thoughts about the mainstreaming of RRI or similar approaches based on the Star Bios 2 experience. So first of all, a recall about some general points that are relevant for us and in several ways already discussed in this event. As I say today, science is a part of society and co-evolves with it. But science-society relationships are deeply changing, and biosciences are at the core of this transformation. The current transformations in postmodern knowledge, global societies, and in science production pose new governance challenges, which RRI, or similar approaches, can certainly contribute to face. This is all the more true in this period of great emergency related to COVID-19, and will be probably also be true in a later period. And we all must also look at the experiences of the research groups, peoples and governments who already have a great deal with a great deal of expertise in this pandemic. We have seen a growth last year, a growth in the importance of approaches related to responsible open research and how else we can define and call it to establish and harmonize the relationship between scientific and technological research and the rest of society. Some example, in Europe, for instance, the strategies and approach like smart specialization, open innovation, open science, responsible research and innovation, and those related to specific social aspects of science, such as ethics and gender, or the US National Science Foundation broader impacts approach, or another example, the principle expressed in the De Jong Declaration on Science, Technology and Innovation Policies for the Global and Digital Age, or the Science, Technology and Innovation Strategy for Africa, and other initiatives, for instance, in Brazil, we have a partner in Brazil, inspired by UN Sustainable Development Goals. There have been and there are many policies and experiences. This process of elaboration and experimentation is going on in search of increasingly relevant and effective solutions. The issue now is that this will become the daily bread for researchers. There is a need to encourage the mainstreaming of the most convincing solutions and to root them deeply and sustainably in the complex fabric of scientific organization and methods, even in biosciences. It is a trend that is actually taking place, also out of necessity. See the scientific exchanges needed to face COVID-19. What I can say about the mainstreaming of responsible research based on StarBios 2 experience is that it is necessary to act on several fronts at the same time, at least four, based on our experience in this project. Of course, it's not systematic or valid everywhere and every time. We talk about a sort of a quadruple contextualization anticipated by Carla this morning. The organizational contextualization, disciplinary or sectoral one, geopolitical and cultural contextualization, historical contextualization. These aspects are deepened in our guidelines, Andrea Bekic talked about before, in the reports on the experiences of the 9 action plans of StarBios 2, in our final strategic document, and in other project documents, if you want to go more in depth. organizational contextualization. Here, mainstreaming takes place through the promotion of a greater embedment of RRI or similar approach within the individual research organization, universities, national institutes, private centers, private research centers, and so on. The experience of StarBios 2 as a whole has highlighted that RRI makes sense only if it is useful for carrying out better research and innovation and for providing solutions to the problems related to the professional life of the various actors within the research organization. This means, in any case, going beyond the business as usual and that the embedment process is not automatic. It brings about negotiations, conflicts, backlash that have to be managed. We talked about before the role of the core teams that work better when they are able to share visions, communicate effectively, to build strong leadership, to create skills, and also are able to mobilize human, material, logistic resources. There are some issues at stake for governance related to this specific kind of contextualization. For instance, I mean, how RRI can influence in some way the vision of research contents, the aspects of the organizational structure that have to be affected, the concrete steps to take for implementing an RRI strategy or model, as said in the StarBios 2 guidelines. Then, disciplinary or sectoral contextualization. This type of mainstreaming consists in adapting the responsible research and innovation to a specific discipline, for example, biotechnology, or to an entire sector in a broad sense, such as that of biosciences. Here, some issues at stake for governance are, for instance, the identification of potential social, economic, and cultural impacts of the new biological research and innovation waves, and related open ethical issues, as also Rick Roberts stressed before. The effective adoption of a multidisciplinary approach with the consequent change of professional models, operational and organizational routines, career paths, educational programs, and so on. And these issues are particularly relevant within academia, of course. The full exploitation of potentials of data sharing, for instance, in the field of pandemics and other global phenomena. The full introduction of gender and other RRI variables in biological research. Then, a further possible level of RRI mainstreaming aims to identify forms of adaptation, or rather reshaping, of this approach to the various geopolitical and cultural contexts, as we have seen this morning in the session about the global dimension of RRI. Some issues at stake for governance at this level, for instance, the features of the national research system regulation and so on, the economic structure of the countries or particular territories, and the relations between research and industry, the role of local philosophies and cultures, for instance, see the inspirational role of the community philosophy of Ubuntu in the world of South Africa research. The use of traditional knowledge in research and innovation, for instance, in pharmacopoeia and botany, and related patent and intellectual property right issues. The connection among different research and education systems, scientific cooperation, joint degree, and so on. Another level of RRI mainstreaming can be related to the ability of science to respond to the challenges that the current events poses from time to time, and of which the COVID-19 pandemic is only the last serious example, and to prevent them as much as possible. The combination of care and responsiveness stressed by Phil McNaughton this morning. Some issues at stake for governance at this level could be, among others, the construction or reconstruction of public trust in science and scientists, the link between research results and decision making, the forms of exchange and evaluation of information and knowledge, the decision about the allocation of research funds, the mobilization of the different generations and categories of researchers, the channels and method of communication with other sectors of society and with the general public. Various types of actors can play a major role in this four level of mainstreaming of responsible research. I mean, the components of research organizations, scientists, managers, technical administrative staff, students, and other external players, companies, citizen associations, citizen science approach, local government, and so on, up to the funding bodies and decision makers. National, European, and international policies, to me, are called to support the contextualization of RRI and actors involved in it, to manage and drive in an effective and sustainable way the increasingly intense and widespread relations linking science to society. It's a reflection that must continue with constant attention to the science-society dynamisms. We, as Starbios II, have tried to do our best. Thank you very much.